Hello, how you going? Sorry, I thought my phone was doing funny things. So here I am, the creative mess again, and I have been loving tea at the moment. I love drinking tea. It's something I do every day, and it got me thinking. I love Earl Grey tea and I've been drinking lots of that. However, the other night I had a look on the back of the package of an Earl Grey tea and it said that it only contains 3% bergamot flavouring. And I was like, oh my God, they're not even using real bergamot. So that really upset me and I was like, okay, there must be a better way of drinking it and it must be much a healthier version of drinking than drinking flavouring. So I decided I have to make my own tea, and how easy is it? And I wanted to share with you all around the world how easy it is. And to celebrate, Young Living have just partnered with our farm in a bergamot farm. And if you didn't know, most of the world's bergamot is grown in Italy, which is beautiful. It actually comes from my husband's father's region, which is in Reggio in Calabrese. It's actually in Reggio in Italy. So for those that love Earl Grey tea as much as I do, you can make your own at home, and it's really, really simple. And you know exactly what goes in it. So you're not using any artificial flavorings or colorings or anything like that. So here, this is where the Bella Vista farm actually distills the bergamot essential oil. So it's actually culinary, so you can actually use it to flavor your foods and beverages. I use it for skincare. You can use it for lots of different things. What I love about cold pressed bergamot is that it is the distinctive fragrance that is made with Earl Grey tea. So for those, you either love it or you don't, but you do acquire a taste to it. So the more you drink it, you know, and do some research on it, because the health benefits are absolutely amazing for bergamot. So that's probably the reason why it was put into a tea those many, many moons ago. And so what makes bergamot so amazing is that it's got a very complex citrus taste to it. So it's really good for putting into summer dishes if you do a lot of seafood. And basically, if you're not sure what a bergamot is, it's sort of crossed between an orange and a lemon. So it's got a very distinctive sour orange lemon taste to it, but it's very zesty, and that's what I love about it. So it really helps uplift that tea. And especially when you drinking tea, you want to uplift and you know, get the best benefits out of it. So it's beautiful, it's great. We use it a lot in our perfumes as well, cosmetics, lotions. It's great for its cleansing properties. So you know, there's so many different ways that you can use bergamot, but this is how I do it. So basically, I just get my teapot. I've got this here, black tea. Try and source a really good organic tea that has been grown somewhere in the world that hasn't been used with pesticides and all those sorts of things, okay? So you know, please beware when you're buying your tea. I always get my tea leaves you know, straight from you know, a really good source that they don't use pesticides, and that's one of the main things that I don't want in my tea. This is really simple. So I'm a black tea drinker, so if you like it with milk, you probably like it stronger. But for those, you can change this recipe. It's super, super easy. So that is just organic black tea, okay? And I just put one for a pot size. This probably does two cups. I just do one teaspoon. And in that, it's really, really easy. And then you just add your water. So just putting that in there. And then while that's going, I just add one drop. Now, depending on how strong flavoring you like, or how your taste buds are, if you're really strong tea, like, you know, really, really dark tea, then you could go 2 teaspoons and then 2 drops of bergamot. But I like it just just on the taste, the side that I can taste it, you know what I mean? Like, so it's not too thin. And then basically you just let that steep. And because I don't like it strong, I then tend to pour it out pretty quickly. So there you go, you can see the color there. And because I'm a black tea drinker, and I have to use my beautiful cup that my friend Kylie Bright, and a big shout out to her, bought me for my birthday. And it says, "You are beautiful." And to all the women out there, the children, and anyone watching today, you are beautiful. And don't let anyone else tell you anything other. So there you go. This is my afternoon tea. So Earl Grey, made with Young Living Bergamot oil. That is the only oil in the world I would recommend to use if you're going to use it to flavor or add it to your beverages, because I know that it is authentic. It has, we have a seed to seal process, and what you get in this beautiful little bottle is exactly what comes out. And that's the lifeblood of that beautiful bergamot tree. So happy afternoon wherever you are. An Earl Grey tea for me, and I hope you try that too. Oh my God, it's so beautiful. Take care.